Congratulations.
Thanks.
Congratulations.
Thanks, Mary.
Those are so fun to do.
Yeah.
I could hear Mary, you know, as I read further on, so.
Well, and I mean, we must say, really appreciate people taking the time to submit those nominations.
Yeah.
Everyone who's leaving, please drive carefully.
Yeah. Thanks for coming out.
Thank you. I'll move on to the next one.
All right.
Moving on. How's
yes.
that? So, as most of you know, January is Board of Recognition Month. And so we would like to recognize all of you for your service and dedication to the Midland Public Schools children. And for two of you, your start down that journey, and for Mary's case, a little different role, but certainly a new journey and a lot of dedication to children, as you'll see as we work through this process as we go forward. In front of you, you have some books. And so, as been our tradition for the last few years, we send Cindy out on some fun, picking out books for kids.
Yeah.
And she comes back with them. And we donate these to the library in your name. And under the front cover is your name in those. We have books for each level. I believe this one is the high school level. Mm-hmm. Did I do that one right?
Middle.
Okay. Middle school level here, high school level here, and the one in front of you is your, your elementary. I'll send them around.
Oh, okay.
High school
oh,
here.
Cute.
And I'll send them around as well. Traditionally, you get some artwork from one of our teachers' classrooms, and with our 2 days off last week, the artwork didn't get completed.
Okay.
And so you'll be receiving those. We want to do it next month, board meeting, or we'll do something in between,
okay.
But we're going to have to adjust a little bit because we missed a couple days of school and they didn't get them done. So that's always fun as well. And again, thanks for your service and look forward to the coming months of doing good things for kids. So.
Great.
I think Mr. Sherrill should read that to us.
I'm getting pretty good. I have a granddaughter now, so I'm getting good at reading stories. So.
Excellent. Well, she can go check this out in the library.
This is awesome.
All right. Moving on. Item 4.0 is presentations to the board, our bond construction bids. So I'm going to turn this back over to you, Mike.
Yes, and if any of your questions get too high, I have Daryl Dombrow from Barton Mall Construction here to fill in if I don't do that correctly. So quite a list we have in front of you. If you recall, we had quite a bit of work that we've been working on to get prepared for this. So we have our full renovations and secure entrances at Woodcrest in Plymouth, and we have secure entries, no, excuse me, not quite yet secure entries, and we have auditorium as well. The second part of the auditorium awarded for bids as well. So quite a bit of work there totaling totaling almost 11.9, is that correct, Daryl? Total, if you total the two packages going forward. They are broke down in actually three packages for you here. The first one is asbestos 4.1, and it's an abatement at Plymouth and Woodcrest Elementary Schools. Anytime we go in, you often find still asbestos in some of our buildings and glues and moldings and behind windows and doors. And so, I mean, not a lot left, but you're getting some pipe insulation. And so that first bid there, we are taking the low bidder, and it's Quality Environmental Services, Inc. of Gladwin, Michigan, $281,080. Nice. So we're looking for approval on that first item, 4.1.
So moved.
Support.
Angela's going to take the motion.
Sorry.
Sorry, I was writing down the name of the book. Yep. I'll pass it on. All right, so at this time, if I could entertain a motion.
So moved.
All right,
support.
Thank you, Brad. Support advice.
Yeah, we're a little out of order. Angela would normally go through these, but you didn't feel ready.
Well, I wanted to make sure. No, yeah. I could have gone through. Yeah. All right, so at this time, is there any questions that anyone has or any discussion? I know we went through a lot of this at FFO, but
I thought it was great with the bids. It looked like we had a lot of bids, and it created a neat atmosphere to be real competitive and get a good price, and hopefully we'll have some savings then that we can use for other projects. So I was pretty happy about the bids.
There were multiple bids received for each project, correct? Except for the one that's going to be rebid.
Is that correct? So let me say a little bit then about the whole package for you as we go through. Low bidder in all cases. We did split one up to get the two low bids, two different buildings. You may have saw that. Lots of bids in each category. I can't remember how many categories, Daryl, 23?
There was 23 categories and 72 bids.
So nice showing. But we did have one, flooring, mainly in the auditorium, but time of bid, some of the contractors that we normally were getting on flooring in the earlier projects were quite busy doing some other things. A lot of that's picking up, and they're really not school specialties, and some of them do hospitals, and so we're going to have to go back out on flooring a little bit. We weren't comfortable where we were with flooring, so we pulled that one back.
Okay.
Right, is there any other questions or discussion? All right. All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Aye.
All those opposed? All right. 4.11 passes.
4.12, Central Auditorium Renovations Phase 2. So we did the mechanical and some of those pieces first. And so this is a little more in the house, the sound, the seating, those type of things as you go through there. We're going to ask you to award the general trades to Robig Construction, Inc. of Saginaw at $488,150. Aluminum entrances for Architectural Glazing Systems, Inc., Mount Morris, Michigan, $172,377. Painting, we're asking for Hawk Painting, Inc. to be approved out of West Branch at $101,606. Theater stage equipment, Tobin's Lake Sales, Inc., out of Ann Arbor, Michigan, $239,000. Fixed auditorium seating, Irwin Seating, Inc., out of Grand Rapids, Michigan, $204,000. $263, and electrical will be Ted's Electric, Inc. out of Rhodes, Michigan, $464,000 even. So total package there we're asking to award is $1,669,396.
All right. This time I'll entertain a motion for 4.1.2.
I motion to accept item 4.1.2.
Support.
All right. Moved by Pam. Support by Scott. Are there any questions or comments on this?
I guess I would just say that the auditorium is one piece we spent a lot of time with our user groups. You know, two unique user groups, drama and music, where they tend to have some like interests, but some different interests in that facility. And so we've tried to accomplish everything they could. We've had to do that in a variety of ways. You know, changing the stage to blow out the building was something we could afford to do. But there was a lot of new technology features to be able to meet what I think the users are going to like. I think we're going to have a very good product when we're done.
And remind the audience again, this will be ready by the fall of 2017 also?
Correct.
Okay. All right. Any other discussion? Okay, all those in favor say aye.
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 All those opposed? All right, moving into 4.1.3.
And that is a bid for the elementary renovations, as I spoke of earlier, and the additions as well. So each of those elementaries are getting their additions to them. And we're asking concrete to be awarded to Wobig Construction Company out of Saginaw, $314,518. Masonry to Davenport Masonry Inc. out of Holt, Michigan, $859,401. Structural steel to Men of Steel Inc. out of Marlette, Michigan, $325,800. General trades to Wobig Construction Inc. out of Saginaw, Michigan, $646,695. General trades to Three Rivers Corporation in Midland, $637,563. Roofing Strang Construction Inc. of Chesaning, Michigan, $489,950. Aluminum Entrances Architectural Glazing Systems Inc. out of Morris, $535,521. Concrete Moisture Vapor Control System, Elite Coatings Inc. out of Maurice, Michigan, $107,535. That is the fix at Woodcrest. Some of you know we've had moisture problems there. Mm-hmm. Painting, Hawk Painting Inc. West Branch, $133,392. Flooring, DF Flooring Inc. out of Flint, Michigan. Regal Flooring Inc. out of Flint, Michigan. Two different names, same company, $494,396. Locker Steel Equipment out of Pontiac, Michigan, $127,000, and it's in that category, but it is northeast that those lockers are going in. Mechanical William E. Walters, Inc., out of Flint, Michigan, $2,649,910. Electrical Masters Electric, Inc., out of Gladwin, $996,290. Classroom AV Systems Masters Electric, Inc., Gladwin, Michigan, $270,700. AV Systems Innovative Communications, Inc., Saginaw, Michigan, $398,036. Site Work, Pat's Great All Service, Inc., Midland, Michigan, $1,089,000. Total bid, $10,058,707. A lot of local vendors. Sometimes I think people mix up when you see Saginaw or you see Flint, and you think not local, but many of our residents are employed by these type of companies as well.
All right, at this time I'll entertain a motion for 4.1.3.
Move we accept item 4.1.3.
Support?
Support.
All right, moved by Lynn, supported by Mary. Any other discussion or questions on this?
We're going to be busy.
Yeah. So I think this is starting in April, right, is the time frame to break ground with the plan to have it done by the following April of 2018.
End of the following school year.
Right.
Yep.
So the multi-purpose room additions will start in April and we'll turn over to the building in December. When we turn that portion of the project over, we'll move back into the existing multi-purpose room and renovate that with a schedule of like 2 months. And then the bulk of that work will happen in the traditional summer schedule, so like the classroom AV systems, carpet, heating and cooling, windows, think classrooms, office renovations will happen in that June, July, August period.
All right, thank you. So we just ask that everyone is very understanding over the next year if those are your buildings that, you know, for progress, we're going to have to probably put up a little dust and noise for a little bit, but like you say, you have done this before and you're doing as much over the summer as possible so as to not be disruptive.
Probably a STEM activity to watch a building go up.
You know it.
There probably will be some learning moments in there.
Oh, yeah, definitely.
Yeah.
So, are there any other comments or questions?
I think it's exciting. We're getting going.
It is.
You know, we've talked so much, and now it's kind of fun
You really did.
Put it to the ground.
We've done boilers in the middle schools, but that's not seen. We've removed some duplexes. That's not really seen. And the Central Park scene, but it's not necessarily at the buildings where kids presently are already at. So this, I think the feel's going to really get feeling now that we're doing the work. Yep.
Excellent. So, and then there will be more coming next month, too. So.
Yep, we still got more coming at you.
All right. At this time, all in favor, say aye.
Aye. Aye.
All those opposed? All right. Let's get started. All right, moving into item 5.0. This is request to address the board. I think, do we have any Okay, if anyone at this time would like to address the board, welcome you to come up to the podium. All right, seeing none, we will move into item six, which is curriculum instruction and assessment. So I believe, Pam?
I have the study committee minutes. Is that what you're looking for?
Yes, I am.
Okay. On Monday, January 9th, the study committee met. Scott Cochran and Lance Ransom were guest presentations, and we met at Dow High School in the Auto Tech Lab. For Auto Tech, the Auto Tech Lab tour, the Curriculum Instruction Assessment Committee was provided a tour of the lab by Auxiliary Curriculum Specialist Scott Cochran and Auto Tech Instructor Lance Ransom. The tour included observations of students working in the lab, a review of curriculum components, surveys of equipment, and safety protocols. It was neat. We got to go around and actually talk to the kids and ask them questions, and they're very knowledgeable, and in every case, you know, we're able to identify the parts of the car that I honestly didn't know. Mr. Sherrill knew a lot more than most of us did. So it was impeccable. It was a really neat experience. The lab was fabulous, and I can see why there's so many students who love Auto Tech. Then we talked about the countywide CTE collaborative. Scott Cochran provided the committee with a progress update on the inaugural year of the countywide CTE collaborative. The aim of the initiative was to provide broader access to CTE courses for all students in Midland County. 36 students from Bullet Creek, Coleman, and Meridian participate in 5 MPS CTE programs. 12 MPS students are now accessing the agri-science program at Coleman High School, and 9 students are attending the Greater Michigan Construction Academy. I've got a special place in my heart for that program. 2 years ago, Mr. Sherrill asked if anyone on the board wanted to participate in exploring our futures. And I participated in that and co-chaired a team with Dick Dolinsky. And one of our outcomes was a proposal to the Midland Area Community Foundation for almost $100,000 grant that made this possible. So this, along with a lot of effort from each of the schools and a great collaboration, it's really exciting to see. So far from last year to this year, the number of students that are moving from school to participate has grown by 124%. So a lot of great news, and I'm looking forward to see what happens next year, because I bet it'll grow even further. And that was it.
All right. Thank you very much. So do you, Brian, or major change proposals?
Yeah, we bring to you tonight 3 major change proposals for action. These major change proposals were presented for information at our last board meeting. Just a quick recap of them. The most simple is Algebra 8. That's a name change to Algebra A that helps us satisfy the NCAA clearinghouse requirements for that course. French 2, German 2 alteration, that adds an option for students to take those courses at a 0.3 level. It doesn't add a new course, just simply allows the teacher to differentiate within it. And that's a continuation of a major change proposal that we had last year. So students in French 1 and German 1 right now that are choosing to take it at a 0.3 option will be able to continue into the 0.3 option as they progress in their coursework. And the biggest major change proposal we have is the integration of Project Lead the Way launch at our K-5 elementaries. This will serve as the foundation for our STEM instruction. And you will see this integrated fully at Central Park next year and the rest of the elementaries the year after.
Time, I will take a motion to approve the major change proposals.
So moved.
All right. Moved by Mary.
Support.
Support by Patrick. Are there any questions or discussion?
I would add that Project Leadway Launch is fully funded going forward by our local foundations, so we want to make sure we recognize them for doing so.
Thank you very much. I keep reading just in different places, Project Lead the Way, just all over. Earlier this week, or last week, today's only Monday, I was reading an article just about getting girls interested in STEM, because of course very near and dear to my heart, and it actually, in this article, mentioned Project Lead the Way as one of the current initiatives that's going on in a lot of communities. So it was, you know, just another place that I have read that. So very, very excited that we are going that route. Any other comments?
Just a comment to anyone listening, if they wanted to know more, you can just Google Project Lead the Way, and there's great information out on the web. So it's a wonderful place to dig deeper.
I think it's nice, too, that we have that distinction available for continuing on with, like, German Point 3 and making that option available to students that really want to excel.
Yes. All right. This time, all those in favor, say aye.
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 All those opposed? All right. Major change proposals pass. Moving on to item 7, finance, facilities, and operations. Patrick, if you would review our minutes.
Yep, I have
from
minutes
Sunday's meeting.
From January 9th. Angela, myself, Mr. Cheryl, Mr. Cooper, we're all present, along with Daryl from Barton Mallow. At the meeting, we had a bond update. Mr. Dumbro shared and discussed with the committee the timelines, bid deadlines, and awards on upcoming bond projects across the district. To be awarded at tonight's meeting, which we have been through already, so seeing that, the board meeting are scheduled abatement projects, Central Auditorium Phase 2, Woodcrest and Plymouth renovations and additions, and AV equipment for Central Park, Plymouth, Woodcrest, and the auditorium. The secure entrances and the STEM playground and outdoor learning spaces are scheduled to be awarded at the March board meeting. The next FFO meeting Monday, February 13th at 5 o'clock.
All right. Thank you very much.
I have two items in the way of gifts for you tonight. The first is for information. We have gifts totaling $152,979.40. Just to remind everybody, especially since we're starting new here with new board members, the details of this always follow after the broadcast on the screen, mm-hmm. so everybody can see a little closer exactly how much is given. In this case, it ranges from some parents giving us money for STEM materials in classrooms, for transportation for boys' golf, some clothing for students from the Jefferson Parent Advisory Committee, some books, copies, and some student fees and transportations. From the Strohsacker Foundation, we have the match to the parents that gave, but we also have $150,000 that's part of the STEM grant, which you approved earlier. It's coming, as you know, over time, each foundation providing us that money in a little different way. And so this is that installment from the Strohsacker Foundation. And then under 7.3, we have some kind of interesting gifts. we got a Volkswagen Beetle. It's going to that auto tech program you talked about. So
hey, we saw that up on the
web. We don't often get that, but it kind of goes up there with the antenna we got at Midland High. If you remember when the radio club came, all of a sudden we had an antenna up. So we get some different things, but that's very good. Kids will use it out there. And then CPI Fluid Engineering donated 21 books of Dial-A-Ride tickets and gas cards, which equals about $750 to give to MPS families in needs, which we very much appreciate.
Thank you. Once again, thank you so much to the community that is so incredibly supportive of our school district. All right, moving into item 8.0, human resources. I think, is there no meeting?
No meeting.
All
nope.
right, turn it over to Mike, yep. Ben.
Board and staff extend their sympathy to the family of Mr. Paul Warner, who passed away on January 2nd. Mr. Warner was a principal at Jefferson and Central Middle School for 34 years, retiring in 1994. And then we have some staff members who have announced their retirement, and so I'll go through those as well. Beth Chapman, a media preparer professional at Plymouth Elementary as of June 15. Barb Jocks, elementary music teacher as of June 16. Brenda Michalski, paraprofessional at Midland High, April 21. And Diana Ripke, bus driver, transportation, January 9. So some retirements.
All right.
You'll be seeing some of those more coming in the next few months.
All right. Well, thank you very much to all of them for their service to our district. All right. Moving into item 9.0, correspondence to and from the Board of Education. Item 10, our scheduled activities. As you can see, tonight's organizational and regular meetings, and followed by all the other meetings that were approved during our organizational meeting. At this time, we'll move into, we'll do study session first? And
yes.
Okay.
Yep.
We'll move into our study discussion section. At this time, hearing from board members. So, Patrick, I will start with you.
All right. I wanted to, stress the work that's being started at elementaries, the other elementaries. I've heard from many parents in the district, when am I going to get mass? When am I going to get my work done at the school? I think it's important to know that everybody will get some improvements and some work done to the school. And it's nice to see Woodcrest and Plymouth getting some work done. It's real, but if you see that amount of money, it certainly makes it a little more real tonight. I think when we first started this discussion was the schools hadn't had debt in, was it 50 or 60 years?
Yep.
But it's definitely needed to improve our aging facilities. Shining stars every month. I'm amazed at the years of service we see out of our volunteers or our parapros and teachers, and it's I think that's what makes it special is that the people who have been here for so long and know the schools, know the history, know grandparents and grandkids, and it's I appreciate it. Welcome to our new members. Looking forward to working with you. I was gonna, Bob kind of stole my thunder there, but always, as always, the money and generosity of the community is always wonderful. When I saw the beetle tonight, I said I hadn't seen much like that in a while, but it's always impressive to see the amount of money that comes through. Tonight, it seems like every other donation is a STEM, some kind of STEM attachment to it, so nice to see that rolling too.
Very good. Yeah. It's Martin Luther King Day, Day of Doing. I want to share a quote. Life's most persistent question is, what are you doing for others? Today, I know a lot of the students in Midland Public Schools, a lot of the high school students were sharing their time. I know we had students at Senior Services, East Lawn, I think there was another elementary school at the library, and I thought it was just a wonderful tribute to being able to celebrate Martin Luther King Jr. and as a tribute to the four students who came to us 2 years ago and asked for this day. And I'm excited where it started, and I think there can be a lot of growth in that doing for others theme that they've started. So I'm looking forward to watching that grow. Very excited about all the bond work that we talked about, and it's going to be a really interesting year, and I don't think we'll be able to turn around without seeing something being done. I remember at Plymouth when we had a fourth grader in Debbie Hayes' class, and there was a Consumers Energy guy out working on a pole, and all the kids were staring out the window, and she had a mic on, and she said, just a minute, and she ran out, and she interviewed this guy while the kids were all plastered against the windows watching, and I thought, what an opportunity for a teacher to take advantage of something like that. So I'm hoping for some of the same stuff. So you might prepare the guys for questions for rogue teachers. I mentioned the scheduling of the CTE classes. It's great to see the growth and the sharing from district to district. One of the students we talked to in the auto tech program said he got involved in auto tech. His mom was a little nervous about it, wanted him to continue band, but he did the auto tech, and then he decided that he loved engines and wants to go to Michigan Tech for an engineering degree. And I thought, what a story. I mean, that is engaging and exciting, and I think any parent or student would be thrilled with that. Mike, you mentioned that our sub rates are increasing for substitute teachers, and I think that's wonderful that we can do that. I'm hoping that'll make a difference in being able to help us get more subs into the classrooms on those days we really need it. Sorry, I'm going on and on, but Mr. Sherrill went to the Midwest Superintendent Conference, and you did that every year now that I've been on the board, and every year I'm floored. I mean, you go on your own dime, you share the information, and you're excited about what you've learned. And I think we're very fortunate to have you go for continuous education and bring that back to our district. So thank you for that.
Yep.
The Booster Bash is March 24th. It's a great time every year. I'll be going to that. I hope you do too. And We had horrible weather last week, but I'm glad that Twitter is out there to keep us all entertained and let us know when we get to sleep in.
Keeps me up at night buzzing.
Thank you. That's all I have.
I just wanted to say I'm excited to get started on my four-year term. It's very exciting to hear Pam talk about the Greater Michigan Construction Academy. Hopefully in the future we'll be able to talk about them more. That's very near and dear to me. And I just want to say thank you very much to all the 70-plus bidders, Daryl, that for all the contractors out there. There's more coming. And just want to say thank you to all of them. Me, as being a contractor, I know all the time and energy it takes to put into those bids. It takes a lot of work. And just to have them, thank them and have them stay tuned, there's more coming.
Thanks for acknowledging that, and welcome both of you. It's really exciting to have you guys on the board with us. And on behalf of all of us, I think we're all looking forward to a great 4 years of charging our district forward. Dang it, Pam, you just talked about everything.
You hit it all. I know. I'm like, there's nothing so, left to say.
Angela's going to start on the other end next time.
Yeah, another congratulations to our shining stars. Mary Sanborn has taught two of my children very recently, and she is just a phenomenal person. She's so great with the kids. Every day, my son Connor and my son Sebastian came home just excited and ready to go back to learn more. And Cameron, my daughter, who is in Kelly Jolly's class, will hopefully move on to Mary's class next year. So I'm excited about that. And then two more years, maybe I'll get Alistair in there. So looking forward to that.
You're not done having kids, are you?
I was saying, we can support our district with our children.
Yeah, keep the lights on, right?
Yes, exactly.
So thank you to everybody for all the wonderful financial donations, especially the Strohstacker Foundation for their contribution thus far. Just an all-around pretty good meeting, so that's all I have. Thanks a lot.
Great, Mary.
I just wanted to comment on that CTE programs, and I had a chance to talk with some kids that are going to the Coleman Agricultural, and it's all STEM. I mean, they're exploring things and learning things, and you know, they have time on the bus to do some study work. And I also subbed in a class where there were kids that were coming in for the health class that we have for the nursing program, and kids from Sanford and Coleman both in that class. So that was an interesting mix in there, and seeing why they were interested in doing it, and a nice opportunity that we can exchange from one district to another. And the other thing I wanted to comment on is these books. Good choices on the books. One of them I own myself, at the 33 Women in Science Who Changed the World. And I like that they're focused on women's roles in science, because so often it goes by the wayside. For years, women couldn't even think about studying to be a doctor. It was just not allowed, and one of those books brings that up. So it's pretty cool to get that in the hands of kids.
Good.
Well, I was going to say thank you, too, for getting these books. And my favorite part is taking them to the schools. So I know for mine, I love to go and deliver them, and you know, let them know that it's fun to be a school board member. And right now, welcome to our new ones. I think you're coming in at the best time in the last 15 years, at least in my experience. So there's a lot of really exciting things going on. There were in the past, but we had our challenges, a lot more challenges along the way. So welcome, and I hope you enjoy it as much as the rest of us have done. And congratulations to Kelly and Mary. It's always fun to honor our employees, and who don't always get the recognition that they deserve. Let's see. Exams are coming up, I believe. I don't have a child in school anymore, but
oh, they are.
I know that's always a stressful time. So good luck. I see there's a lot of neat things going on in the community too to support our kids with exams at the library and at schools, and so they can make exams a little more fun than I remember exams. So
I'll tell Sarah you said that.
Mm-hmm. Yep. And I think on that note, as we recognize Martin Luther King today and appreciate everything that that people do for one another. I'm very grateful that I'm involved with Midland Public Schools and all that everyone does to make it a great place.
All right, well, I think everyone has pretty much said everything, but I want to welcome Brad and Mary once again to the board, and then thank everyone for their willingness to volunteer and fulfill this role. The school board is a lot of behind-the-scenes work. There's a lot of things that we do that the public probably doesn't even realize. A lot of work goes on to be on the board, but we all do it because we just have such a passion for this district and for our kids that are in this district. And so thank you all very much for honoring us today with the books. I also love the idea of putting books in the library. It's like very good choices this year. Thank you. And I'll turn it over to you, Mike.
I wrote to you last week about possibly surveying our community on graduation. Mm-hmm. We've had a couple people even come in front of us who talked about conflicts of graduation going on the same night with maybe cousins or children in both graduation ceremonies. Approached the subject once earlier, and I can't say I had a lot of takers, but lately it seems like more people are talking about graduation location as well as the timing of when we occur. This wouldn't be probably something we'd do this year, too short of a notice, but I did go over and I did have a meeting with Paul Barbeau at the Dow Diamond as a possible location. He's going to put a proposal to us and give it back. I really did that more because I wanted to get the information to survey our community. So, you know, the Dow Diamond could be a great location. One thing I didn't realize when I did talk to him, though, is they do so many weddings when they're not playing as well that it could be difficult to get in at times. And so they're suggesting maybe a Sunday format. And I have been in a district where we graduated on a Sunday. It was an issue. Was not an issue. With two graduations, you know, we'd have to, right after a church time and then later in the afternoon. But many people liked it because they could bring relatives in on Friday night or have the graduation party on Saturday and then graduation on Sunday. So it worked for families as well. But we certainly will pull them. If you think of an outdoor venue on a nice June day, you can't beat that much. But we'd have to have a backup plan, obviously, for rain. And I've handled those before as well. And we would use our gyms. The gyms, Pam and I and Lynn sat through one last year that we weren't sure we were going to make it through. And so it was so warm. And you think of some of our seniors sitting in those bleachers with no backs on them for a while. I think we could probably do a better venue, but I certainly will leave that up to our stakeholders. But I'd like to gather information, survey the community, get at least a consensus, and then maybe we bring it in front of you about going forward on that one. So early on that one, no one panic. That's done deal, but we'll gather information when we go forward. Pam did mention the sub rates, and so we did raise the hourly rate to an $80 a day rate. Really, our sub rates were minimum wage rates. All districts, we all froze those for years. During the hard times, and it's time to bring that up a little bit. And sub pool, the size of the sub pool is one issue. The other issue that most districts have is subs on those real nice Friday, first time it's sunshine in the spring. They're not really anxious to pick up the phone on those days as well. And so we have to maybe incentivize our subs. And so I wrote to you about a surge rate that we may use on some of those days that would bring that rate up slightly higher to try and encourage them to call as well. So we're trying to solve that problem. We had a little, if you remember, some of you that were here, we had a little issue last spring where we had, 17, 20, 25 classrooms unfilled, and we had a panic one morning where I said, that's it, we got to do something, and so we're going to work on that as we go forward. Pam mentioned Midwest superintendents, and I want to tell you just a little about that. Some of you are new about that, and so I've been going to that group for about 12 years. When I was first interviewed, you guys remember we talked about mentoring, and I talked a lot about somebody who mentored me, and he's 70 years old and still attends this conference. He's been retired for 5 years. So it tells you his passion for education. We're around passionate educators. It's unique, and it's, to me, it's well worth my investment to do it. I would never ask you to send me to Marco Island, Florida on public dollars. So it is a benefit to be on Marco Island, Florida when I'm going to that conference, so I do pay for that. But it's 100 superintendents out of suburban districts out of the Midwest. And so when you go to MAGA conference, there's no networking and there's no connection beyond that. And so when you take a small group of 100 of us who all have something in common, similar size districts, from the Midwest, Missouri, Illinois, Ohio, Indiana, Michigan, Iowa, Wisconsin. I don't think I missed anyone in there. The groups. We all have so many number of seats, so I was fortunate to get one many years ago because of my mentor who got me into this group. We had Doug Reeves. You can Google him. Doug Reeves is a guru on leadership in schools. He's a regular to our event as well. We had a gal named Deb Delisle. She once was the state superintendent in Ohio, who then went to work in the U.S. Department of Ed, and who's now the president of the ASCD. ASCD is our largest curriculum and instruction organization in the country. Those are the type of speakers we bring in there. We have a school law update from multiple attorneys from multiple states, which is kind of unique as well. And so sometimes some of the things that are going on in other states are yet to hit us. LGBT, for example, you know, that really kind of hit Illinois before it hit many of us going forward. And so there's much to be learned on all those pieces as well. We start at 7 in the morning. We do get out in 2 in the afternoon, so there is time to go golf 9 holes. But we make it up for you because we also do a Saturday session from 7 to 2. And so I just want you to know we are working. We do enjoy the sun. So last week when Angela thought I left my location thing on incorrectly, I did it on purpose. I don't hide those things. But I want the kids to also know that I'm not the only one that calls those. I mean, I'm the ultimate call on snow days. But Bob, Brian, and Mike were out on the roads, and all three of them were out each morning giving me feedback. So there wasn't a lot of sleep in the mornings going on as well because they were texting me back and forth. So we had that covered, and those guys did a great job as well.
For any of you that don't know, the kids picked up immediately that he was
in Florida.
Yeah. He was tweeting with them, and I guess there was some pretty funny.
Yeah.
There were some good pictures.
Yeah, there were some good pictures. The one where they posted me on the beach, I want to say, man, that's really flattering. I'm really nice and slender, you know. Trying to get there, guys, but.
Yeah, I don't tweet, but my daughter is giving me the rundown.
And then the last part for me is that I do want to mention that in our audience today we have Mark Eckbarth from MCA, and we are going to take action hopefully later. We'll go into close to discuss it and come out to take action afterwards in public on a tentative deal with the teachers. The teachers ratified this afternoon, so the ball's now in your court. And I want to give Mark a lot of credit for leading the teachers through this process, and it was really a very cordial, nice process going through this time. That's it.
Very good.
If it's time, so we can take a motion to go into closed.
Motion to go into closed.
Okay. I'm trying to think, do we want the students to head out given the weather?
Or yeah. So students, we will deliberate in closed because we're allowed to talk about labor contracts in a closed session. That's allowed by law. But when we take action on our contract, we have to come back out in public. There will be another 5 minutes to do that procedural when we come out, but we certainly don't want to, you don't necessarily need to stay for that because there's some ice out there. You might probably get home, okay?
So if you want, when we moved into closed session, we'll sign your sheets if you want before we actually move in, all right? If you do want to leave and not wait.
Unless you want to stick around.
Yeah, no, you're welcome to. I don't know how long this will take. I just know from my walk-in it was getting icy.
And I would assume it's going to take us about 20 minutes to move you through.
So you can decide. I just don't want you to know that you can come up right now and we'll sign your sheets and you don't have to feel the pressure to stay. So at this time, I need to take a motion, don't I?
Correct, you do.
We move into closed session.
Support.
Mary.
Supported by Mary. All right, any discussion? All those in favor say aye.
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 All those opposed? All right, we will move into closed session, which means everybody will need to leave the room. If you would please. All
if you guys
here
want sign
to turn off your microphone. All right, welcome back. We have come back into open session after our closed session. And at this point, we are on item 13, which is consideration of contract ratification. This is for action. Would you like to say a couple words, Mike? Or should we go right into it?
I think I've said it earlier. I'm setting up okay. In that session. So
excellent. All right. So at this time, I would entertain a motion for contract ratification of the Midland City Education Association contract.
So moved.
All right.
Support.
Moved by Mary. Support by Pam. Is there any discussion or questions at this time?
I'm very pleased with how the whole process went. It sounds like it was very amicable and collaborative, and it's wonderful to be moving forward in a positive direction and doing what's right for the districts and the schools and our educators as well.
Agree. Very cool.
All right, so yes, thank you to everyone involved who was working on this. All right, at this time, all in favor say aye.
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 All opposed? All right, we have a new contract. Thank you.
Thank you.
All right, at this time, is there any other comments before we close? All right, then I will close the meeting at 8:54. Thank you all very much.